Chastiel is surprised to find Nephi, who remembers the knight and says that she could cut off his head, but Chastiel is distressed because she didn't want to hurt her, but Nephi says that he was a sorcerer's apprentice and questions if the knight's job would not be to eliminate them, but the population ends up realizing that this was Nephi and asks if the knight was bothering her by working for a sorcerer. Chastiel tries to retreat, but she is surprised by Manuela, who asks if the knight didn't feel ashamed for bullying this sweet little thing, while the population was revolted because Nephi was a good girl, and they scream trying to kick the knight out, but Nephi says that the girl hadn't done anything to her, leaving everyone not understanding anything. Then Manuela asks what would be the reason for her having this terrible face, while Chastiel cried because even she was worried when she saw a girl looking like it hurt. But let's go to that moment where I ask you to leave the subscription to this channel of dubious quality, and don't forget to like and comment a lot to help me keep bringing videos to you, and let's go for another episode. And a while later they go to the tavern where Chastiel asks for forgiveness for losing her composure, and Manuela starts to tease her because even though it didn't bother her, she seemed to know her, and the girl replies that she saw her in the previous mission, and Manuela questions if then she would hurt her if she went to a mission, making her almost cry again, but Nephi interrupts them and says that now everything was fine. And that time she didn't do it either, nothing against her, and it had been someone else who hurt her master, but that person had already paid for it, making Chastiel remember the knight who was now afraid of plants, and the waitress serves Nephi, who says she couldn't accept it since she didn't have money, and Manuela replies that it was no problem, after all she was the one who would pay, and when she starts to eat she remembers that last night she was doing it for her master and starts crying, leaving the girls worried as she wondered why her master had done that then. Manuela hugs the two girls, and after a while they find out that Zagan had kicked her out, but she didn't know the reason, and Chastiel says that she had thought he was a little decent, but it looked like he was just using her, and Nephi says that he wasn't that kind of person, and Manuela asks if something strange had happened before he expelled her, and Nephi remembers that he had said that he became an archdemon and asks what an archdemon would be. Then Manuela explains that they were the most important among the sorcerers, and this city was ruled by one of them, and at that time the security of the city was great. But since his death some girls began to be taken by force, but apparently the church had caught the guys behind it, and Chastiel remembers her superior saying that Zagan was the real responsible, and Nephi comments that the townspeople didn't seem to like the knights very much, to Manuela replies that they go out for AE showing off and demanding a ridiculous amount of money as a salvation offer, leaving Chastiel upset, but Nephi says that it wasn't the girl he was asking for, then she didn't think it was right to blame her, making the girl emotional. She even says that she understood the reason why that man wanted her around, since she was very nice, but she goes back to the subject of the archdemons and says that they were the symbol of the evil that the knight swore to exterminate, even at the cost of their lives, but they only had 12 sacred swords and there were 13. Archdemons, and even if they lost their lives, there would still be one of them left, and if a new archdemon is chosen, the church would definitely try to eliminate him before he could gather strength, and in addition other sorcerers would also try to attack him to increase his position, making Nephi realize that this would generate conflicts, and wonders if this would be the reason he expelled her, and Chastiel decides to ask if she thought Zagan was capable of organizing several sorcerers to use people in a ritual, and Nephi denies it, after all he was strangely uninterested in weak people, and when he saved a carriage that was being attacked by bandits he described it as a relief from the annoyance, but she thinks he may have also done that to put her at ease, and Chastiel says that she was probably right because he restrained himself when he fought her just because she was a woman, and Manuela doesn't miss the opportunity to tease her and asks what expression it would be this, and if she was looking at a damsel in love, leaving the girl awkward, but she says that when she met him he seemed like someone who needed help or companionship, but refused to admit it and seemed to push people away, which Nephi agreed, although she was surprised that anyone else had noticed, and admits that she wished she had been the only one who had noticed, but was glad that someone else had noticed, and she remembers that the night they met, she saw the moon through the window, which she thought she would never see again, but he joined her and wondered if even now he still asked for help. So she gets up determined to go back to her master, since she was sure that no one could beat him since he was very strong, but that didn't mean that he could be hurt since no one really felt good alone, and so she wanted to be by his side, making the girls happy, and Chastiel decided to do her job and makes Nephi question if she would try to fight him again, but the girl denies it and says that there was a sorcerer impersonating him to do evil, and he couldn't defend him because of his position, but at least he could clear his name, and as they both seemed better Manuela decides to end the day and orders the account to be closed because the knight who would pay, but this was a joke, and asks Nephi to come visit her if she has any problems, and Nephi asks why she was being so kind to her, and the girl replies that this was obvious after all they were friends, making Nephi embarrassed because no one had ever said that before, and Manuela hugs the girl, while Chastiel asked if they could consider her a friend too. Then Chastille teases her and questions if it was right for an angelic knight to be friends with one associated with a sorcerer, but she smiles and says she wouldn't provoke her if they weren't friends, embarrassing them both. But they are interrupted by the knights, and one of them is terrified to see the girl of the plant, and a darkness begins to take the place, and the voice of a man says that it was a beautiful sight, and the darkness becomes thicker, but Chastille throws Manuela away and tells her to run away, which makes the man angry, but he says that it didn't matter and introduces himself as the sorcerer Zagan and sends the knights come to his castle if they want this woman back, and eventually they are captured. And Neffy wonders why he is doing this. And meanwhile, Zagan was looking at the moon, and on the ground were the knights who were in disbelief that he defeated them so easily, and Zagan replies that maybe they shouldn't have fallen into his trap, and remembers having done it with Neffy, and also remembers his scared look, but admits that this way it had been better. After all, she had only spent 2 weeks by his side, and no one would relate what they were each other's, and she wasn't going to take any risks and could have a peaceful life, since the townspeople liked her. But one of the knights holds him back and begs him to return Chastille, and didn't care what was going to happen to them, but she insisted that he wasn't behind those crimes and was even willing to defy his eminence to find the real culprit, so he by the at least had to let her go. But Zagan is confused, after all he didn't know what was going on. And he ends up being surprised by Manuela, who says that she had already warned him that he was not the culprit, and tells Zagan that he needed to help Neffy and Chastille who had been captured, leaving him distressed by wondering if it had taken him too long to distance himself from her. And Manuela asks if he could save them, making Zagan think that if he does this it would be clear that there was a connection between the two, and if that happens the church wouldn't leave her alone. And Manuela questions what he was waiting for, since Neffy was trying to get back to him, why she wanted to be by his side, and asks if the sorcerers didn't care when someone felt that way about them, and if that was the case then why had he been nice to her. And Zagan admits that those pounds on his chest hurt more than anyone else. He wonders if she was really trying to return even after he said something so terrible, and wonders why, but ends up admitting that she didn't even need to see his expressive ears to know that she cared about a villain like him, and thanks Manuela because now he knew what he needed to do, and admits that she was right, since all sorcerers were garbage that just worried about him. They cared about themselves and treated others as disposable life tools, and sorcerers were supposed to consider only what benefited them, and so Neffy belonged to him, so he would turn any idiot who dared to touch her into a bloodbath, and if necessary he would use all his authority and power as an archdemon to protect her, and summons a magic circle and asks if she wanted to join him to save her, and the girl decides to go. After all they were friends, but the knights cling to him and beg him to take them, and Zagan ends up agreeing, but Manuela warns that the girls had been taken by a strange shadow and did not know where they were, but Zagan knew who was behind it and the sorcerers really were beyond salvation. But meanwhile Neffy woke up in a cave with shackles that limited his mana, and his mysticism didn't work in this place that had no nature, but someone goes to them and Neffy says that he had thought he was his master's friend, making Barbados laugh because she never imagined that someone would use those words for a sorcerer, and asks if she has ever heard of Andras, the cursed one who had been the first sorcerer that Zagan had eliminated, and in fact he was her mentor, but it wasn't for the girl to get it wrong, since no sensible sorcerer would care about avenging his mentor, and if Zagan hadn't done that, he would have done it. And what really bothered him was that that castle where they lived and all the money he spent on it, in addition to all the knowledge he acquired, should have been his, and so he started to put the church against him, which didn't work, since his henchmen left many traces and the ones he sent after Zagan took a beating, leaving Chastille surprised because he, who was behind all the disappearances, and questions if he did all that to incriminate Zagan. But Barbados tells her not to be stupid, since the face thief who invented this sacrifice business, since they needed means to carry it out, an important ritual that would demonstrate to the 12 archdemons that he was fit to join them. But it was a pity that the sacrifices had been taken by the church, but now he had them, and the mana of a white-haired elf should be enough to open the portal, but Neffy says that this wouldn't make sense, and Barbados questions if she thought that with that he wouldn't send her dragging to, and she thinks he wouldn't save her, and says she wouldn't want him to bother with that matter, and in fact her master had already risen to the position of archdemon, leaving Barbados surprised and annoyed that he even took his seat as an archdemon. And so he begins to drag Neffy to a magic circle, determined to take the title from him by force. Chastille even offers to be used in the girl's place, but he says that his time would also come, since he needed the highest quality tools for this ritual, making Neffy remember that all his life people called him a tool, unlike his master who never used that word with her. And so she tries to resist, since she was determined to live so that she can join her master again, and even if he yells at her or tries to chase her away she would be stubborn and stay in the castle to make food, and offered her lap as a pillow in addition to doing everything so that he can be happy. But Barbados keeps pulling her, and she thinks that maybe she is not the one to do it, and maybe another precious person will come into his life, but he couldn't be alone, and says that it didn't hurt at all and didn't compare to the pain he felt when he sent her away and it belonged only to her master, so she didn't want him to touch her. Making Barbados angry, he summons his magic and tells her to put herself in his place as a servant. But he ends up being surprised by an outburst with the arrival of Zagan, who praises Neffy's words and expected no less from his apprentice. Marking the end of another episode, thank you very much to those who stayed here, and don't forget that mega moral, with your like, subscription and sharing VLW, and see you next time.